Jessica Rusit from FIIG Securities. Jessica, good to see you there today. Now, yeah, we could say, you know, relatively weak data that's coming through from the US. Just talk us through how those yields are tracking.
Good afternoon, Leanne. Thanks for having me. That's right. We had another weak data set released last night, and that comes after the previous night where we had manufacturing and services data down as well. And so on the back of that, there has been some demand overnight for US Treasury yields. There was also a $26 billion two-year auction as well, which was met with very strong demand. The bid-to-ratio cover for that was at 3.03, which is the strongest demand we've seen since 2015. And that's actually brought the yield on the two-year yield down by one basis point. So that was at 1.33%. And that 10-year yield was also down a basis point as well. And that finished up at 2.13%.
Just on that, with investors, you're having to absorb more of that bond supply. Do you often see a lot more activity off the back of that or as a result?
Yeah, usually actually what you would see is with that extra demand coming to the market is that yields would actually move higher as they try to absorb that extra demand. So it was quite interesting to see that last night it was the opposite, and that was part of that due to the weaker data that was released. It was goods that was down, and so that moved the demand for those and also moved those yields lower as well.
Now, of course, we are looking ahead to a number of central bank speakers. We have John Williams a little later here in Sydney tonight, but then we also have Janet Yellen, which I believe will be very early our morning, about 3 a.m. tomorrow morning or so, hoping to hear, I guess, continuing comments on the positive outlook, the path of interest rate hikes there. Do you think this will move or drive bond markets as we do hear her speak?
Yeah, that's right, at 3 a.m. So I certainly won't be up for that, but I will be watching it tomorrow morning at a reasonable hour to see what she has to say. I don't so much as think that what she will say will have too much of an impact on yields, actually. We've had, as you mentioned, several Fed speakers. We had John Williams here in Sydney. There was also Dudley, Bullard as well. And with all of their comments, they actually haven't moved yields too much at all. They have been trading quite a tight range. Partly that is coming to end of financial year, but also that is because there's been mixed signals coming from the Fed as well. Mm. We have some speakers saying that they're keen for rate increases, while others are saying that we really should be pausing and waiting for stronger data to come through and stronger inflation as well. So I think with that, markets are uncertain, also really aren't buying into the story that Yellen's actually the biggest one to say that they are on track and that they will continue to increase rates. And the market's just not buying that. They're not seeing the data to support it.